Thank you. Evan Petty Whisker Tildrum, thou hast proven thyself worthy. A kingmaker shall be thine.
Where is it?
Oi! Don't be here, man!
Huh.
Oh, the cheek!
Hello?
That's right, man. You went wrong there. Okay. It's beautiful. Righto, my turn.
Come to do some shopping, eh? What else can I do for you?
I'll be seeing you again then.
there.
Oi!
That night, the Sky Pirates celebrated Evan and his friend's success into the wee small hours. They all agreed that Evan was a fine young man indeed, and that he would make an even finer king. And then, morning came.
Evan, you mean to become king of this here world, is that not so?
Yes.
Well, now there's a thing. I see something in you. I'm not the only one.
What are you doing?
The men of Cloudcoil Canyon do hereby swear fealty. We serve you now, your majesty.
So it was that the very Sky Pirates who had once sworn to take Evan's life now swore to devote their own lives to serving him. And with this fledgling following, he took his first steps on the long road to ruling the world.
You seem pleased.
I am. Perhaps I really can keep my promise to Nella.
So you really are going to rule the world. But building a kingdom is hard work, and building a great kingdom, it's not going to be easy.
I know, but I'm going to try.
Spoken like a true leader. You'll be meeting a lot more people soon, Evan. You have to listen to them, all of them. It will make you a better...
I'll try my...
Sorry, I'm talking as if I know everything. But I'm right, I think. Until next time, Evan.
But...
Evan and his motley crew of would-be kingdom builders turned their gaze eastward to the heartlands. These verdant plains were as yet unclaimed by any nation. But would they prove a fitting place for Evan's promised kingdom? Chapter 3.